Mega World Hotels and Resorts. And Mr. Joel Fichardo, General Manager, Grand Westside Hotel, Manila. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with utmost pleasure that we welcome the National Director of Miss World Philippines, Mr. Arnold Vega-Frida. To welcome him is Mr. Jun Gusto. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Miss World 2023, Kristin Bisco, to be welcomed by Mr. Joel Fichardo. We would like to invite our VIP guests and the leaders of MegaWorld Hotels and Resorts for a photo opportunity.
We'd also like to welcome Mr. Kurt Boyan, Mr. World Philippines 2024, to join us in the photo.
For our media guests and friends from the Miss World organization, please join us at the fifth floor for some free refreshments. To the rest of us, please enjoy your day and your stay at the Grand Westside Hotel. Have a
It's good again to see all of you. Can we please give them a round of applause, please? Thank you so much for all your support and for joining us here today as we cut inch closer and closer to this year's edition of Miss World Philippines. Of course, we'd like all of you to please mark your calendars for our coronation night, which will be this coming July 19, Friday at the SM Mall of Asia Arena. Good afternoon once again. My name is RJ Ledesma, truly honored to be your host for today's press conference together with our Miss World 2024. Now, just as a reminder, tonight we will formally be wrapping up our fast track preliminaries with our charity gala and national costume competition. This will be held late tonight at Okada Manila's Grand Ballroom. Looking forward once again to seeing all of you tonight for our fast track preliminaries. And today we are very, very fortunate to have with us not only our Arnold Vega-Frida over here, but we also have right now our reigning Miss World 2024 from the Czech Republic. Ladies and gentlemen, let us please give a warm Filipino welcome to Miss Kristina Piskova. Kristina, thank you so much for joining us. We look forward to hearing from you in just a bit. I'm sure we're all excited to hear from Kristina and, of course, from all of our guests here this afternoon. But right before that, please allow me to acknowledge our great, great hospitality partner who is hosting today's press conference in one of the newest and biggest hotels here in the country, which count over 1,350 rooms. 1,530 rooms. And they were just recently inaugurated by the president himself. From MegaWorld Hotels and Resorts, the largest homegrown hospitality chain here in the Philippines. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause, please, to the Grand Westside Hotel. Thank you so much for having us here today. And with that, let's please welcome Grand Westside Hotel's General Manager, the charming and very amiable Mr. Joel Fichardo. Let's give him a round of applause, please.
Thank you. Mabuhay, magandang hapon. Good afternoon, everyone. Sorry for being late. I think let's go forward from here. I think we will make it all these things very quickly. Again, I'd like to acknowledge the presence of Julia Molly, Chairman and CEO of Miss World Organization, Kristina Piskova. Good to see you in Philippines. Enjoy the rest of the afternoon.
Again, thank you so much, Mr. Fijardo, and thank you so much for the warm Filipino hospitality. I'm sure good friends here from Miss World and of course the rest of our pageant fans will enjoy here this afternoon. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to please welcome here on stage my boss and the National Director of Miss World Philippines, one of the biggest supporters of the Philippines in beauty pageants. Please welcome the very dapper Mr. Arnold Vegafria. Arnold, welcome.
Thank you, RJ. Good afternoon to our media friends from Pageant Media and the mainstream media. Good afternoon to everyone. And of course, thank you so much, Mr. Joe. Mr. Joe Fajardo, the general manager, has given him a warm up applause for hosting tonight today's activity and the official hotel of the Miss World organization. Thank you for Joe, thank you for the new hotel of the Mega World Hotel and Resorts, the Grand Westside Hotel. And thanks to, of course, Nico and to all the top executive teams of the hotel. Thank you. We've been friends and we've been, you know, for many, many years, the Mega World Hotel and Resorts have been very supportive to all, to the organization of the Miss World Philippines. And of course, I would like to thank also this time to extend my gratitude, of course, the Miss World organization. They're here again to support the Miss World Philippines and to be in the charity gala tonight and on Friday they will also join us in our coronation night at the Mall of Asia Arena. Thanks to Miss Julia Morley. Julia Morley is very supportive to all the beneficiaries and charities of the Miss World Philippines, and of course to Steve Morley and to Mr. Grant. And of course, it's an honor for us that the reigning Miss World 2024 is here with us, Miss from Czech Republic, Miss Kristina Zaskova. Thank you for coming and joining us. What you can expect in the charity, I would like to invite, of course, all the media and of course our friends from Grand Westside Hotel to be there tonight at the charity gala in another hotel in Okada. because you still have the venue, right? That's why by next year definitely the charity ball will be held in your hotel too. And what you can expect this time is a very good show because we're showcasing, we have the final challenge, which is the national costume and the top model. We will going to showcase the national costumes and the Philippine dance, and at the same time we're showcasing the top four designers. The collections and the creation of these four designers will be featured in the show, in the top model competition. Who are they? Rian Fernandez. We opened by Rian Fernandez, Louis Pangilinan, Mr. Montoya, and of course, Leo Almudal. So I hope you can come and join us tonight for the charity ball of the Miss World Philippines. And on Friday, we have we prepared a big time show, an event for our coronation night on Friday at the Mall of Asia Arena at 8 p.m. and will be telecast by pay-per-view, by a Signal, and it will be telecast in two networks. We will announce it soon who are the networks who are going to. One is TV5, and of course it will be aired also in other platforms, and that you can watch the live telecast via Signal, via pay-per-view. So we're giving tribute this time to the Filipino music pop culture. So we're giving tribute to the OPM music. So it will be showcased by the Manila, the 60-piece Manila Symphony Orchestra, to be conducted by Rodel Colmenar. So I hope you come and enjoy the night of our coronation night, and it's gonna be fun and something new that we can offer to the public. So thank you for hosting for today's activity, and see you tonight at the charity ball. Thank you very much.
Once again, thank you so much, our National Director of Miss World Philippines, Mr. Al Vigafria. We look forward to seeing all of you again at the charity gala tonight, and of course at our upcoming coronation night on Friday at the SM Mall of Asia. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, at the same time, Arlo continues to build strength upon strength with new innovations for Miss World here in the Philippines. So again, Arnold, we're looking forward to you helping us end our long dry spell and keep the Philippines back on track with our much-needed winning streak here in the country. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, I am truly, truly excited to welcome here right now the Lady of the Hour from the Czech Republic. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome for a few words the reigning Miss World 2024, the very lovely Miss Christina Piskova. Let's please give her a round of applause.
So excited to be here. It's my second time here in Philippines, and same as the first time, the second time I was welcomed with the most warm hugs and people. So thank you for that. Thank you as well to Miss World Philippines organization for taking the best care of us, same as the Grand Westside Hotel. It's my first time here as it was opened 3 weeks ago, and I really enjoyed my stay here. So I can't wait for this week. As you heard, we have an exciting program ahead. We have the Big Charity Gala, and on Friday we will crown the new Miss World Philippines. So I can't wait for that. I came here to support the girls, to meet with all of you, because Filipino people are one of my favorites. I grew up a Filipino woman, and so for me to be here, it's always an amazing experience. So thank you for that.
Again, a round of applause, please, Ms. Christina Piskova. Christina, have this time around, you have a chance not only to enjoy the great hospitality of our friends from the Grand Western Hotel, but also to enjoy the great tourist destinations and, of course, the fantastic Filipino food, which I'm sure the Grand Western Hotel has a lot of here as well. In the meantime, we would also like to acknowledge the presence of our Mr. World Philippines 2024, who will compete in Vietnam this coming September 28th. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause, please, for Mr. Kirk Borda. Thank you so much, Kirk, for joining us. You have our full support, that of the pageant and mainstream media. And at this point, our dear friends from the media, I'm sure you're ready to ask some questions to our beloved Miss World 2024, and of course, a few questions as well to Mr. Aaron Vigafria. So I'd like to open up the floor to a few questions to our friends from the media. Again, when you do approach, please do state your name and the media outfit that you belong to and who you'd like to address our question to. Our mic is there at the middle of the floor. If you can bring it right here to the front, that would be fantastic. Let's turn on the mics. And again, thank you so much to the friends from the media for supporting us. Yes, sir, please.
Good afternoon. I'm Dante Paras from Pageant Chronicle. My question is, how does your life change after winning this world?
Good afternoon, thank you for your beautiful question. It definitely changed completely, because now I have the chance to be the ambassador of Miss World, the Beauty with Purpose ambassador, and with that we started our Beauty with Purpose tour and our tour around the world. I knew since I was a little girl that I want to travel the world, And I knew that to have a purpose in life is one of the most important things. So my heart is so full right now as I can do what I love. And travel the world is something that brings many memories, and I'm so lucky to experience that, not only myself, but with my continental queens. So we're really on this journey together, and it's really, really been a blessing because we visited many countries. One of our first visits were to Mauritius, then we continued to London, New York, Dubai, South Africa, Indonesia, Vietnam, really many countries, and I'm happy to be right now here with you in Philippines.
Thank you, Christina.
Thank you so much. Christina's become a jet setter after Miss World 2024, but at the same time, sharing the advocacies of Miss World all over the world. And our next media friend.
Good afternoon. I'm Ethan Concepcion from Manila Standard, with Christina, sa Arnold Lomong. Christina, which among the nations and advocacies of Miss World are you most active now, or are you busiest now?
At which activities? All right, so we have many activities, as I said, because we travel to many countries, but what's closest to my heart is education. Education is my main advocacy because it's something what I've been interested for so many years. I started several years ago when we were able to raise funds to build a school in Tanzania, Africa. And with that, we were able to provide quality education. And with the name of Miss World, I'm able to do this on a much bigger and higher scale. And with that, we come to many beautiful charity galas, many beautiful activities where we visit children in hospitals, in child centers, because as I said, it's the most important thing to do as a Miss World, really spread the kindness and be here for others. And last week, we actually had the chance in the Czech Republic to fund equipment for disabled people. So I'm very active, and I'm sure that with this year I will do much more, because as I said, with Miss World, your voice is much stronger.
So much follow-up question. You look like a goddess. You're a star. So after your reign as Miss World, do you have plans of entering show business or the entertainment world or making a movies? Or if yes, what role would you like to portray in life?
Oh, I love this question. Actually, one of the things we're doing with Miss World right now is something in the movie industry as well. So let's surprise ourselves. And for sure, I definitely want to continue after my Miss World year. I want to stay definitely loyal to my foundation in the Czech Republic. But when it comes to the entertainment and the show business, maybe some of you know that my hobby and one of my talents is modeling. So I love to do the fashion week. So after Miss World, maybe I would love to go to New York to try the fashion week. And if there is a possibility of a movie, I'm open to that as well. And actually today I was talking to the amazing team here in Philippines who were helping me this morning. And they told me, oh, you look like Aurora. And I said, you know, actually I would love to be a princess in a fairy tale. If there is a movie coming up, please cast me. I'm here for that. So that will be maybe the role.
Thank you
so much. Before everything else, Christoph, I'd like you to please comment now on his outfit. Maybe you've got something to say about his wonderful outfit that he's been wearing here today.
I think it's the outfit of the year, actually. I was so lucky that I've got a piece of that outfit, and I said I'll give it to my dad so he can wear it every day when he goes out with me. I love it, really. I love that outfit.
I think Christina, just for this point, this is a photo together with you on stage, just for the wonderful outfit which you can show.
Oh,
that.
Yes, I'll
let you come
do
on stage
it.
Just to take one photo
on
with us. So we have one photo together with that outfit of yours. And make sure that you have one more to give to her dad, okay? Wonderful, wonderful, customized necktie and suit. Again, a round of applause, please. Thank you so much. Thank you for the opportunity. Thank you for indulging us. And with that, let's continue with our questions, please.
Hello, I'm Norman from Norman, Norman. Ahoy, Christina.
Ahoy! Mabuhay!
Yes. Christina, what is the biggest strength or strengths that you discovered about yourself after winning this one?
One of the biggest strengths, I think, is the endurance. Because as a queen, and not only queen, as a pageant woman, you really need to have the endurance. Because you travel the world, you have a tough schedule, and sometimes I don't even understand how I'm able to sleep 3 hours a day, then work the whole day. But if you really love something, you have the passion, you can handle everything. So I think this would be the answer, endurance.
Quick follow-up question. You're still very young, but as Miss World, by the time you enter green, you will be leaving a legacy for the organization. What kind of legacy do you want to leave in the Miss World organization?
In Miss World, back in India earlier this year. At what point did you realize during the competition that you had a chance to win this title? Because I'm asking this in the context that, you know, Miss World Philippines is currently ongoing, and for sure all the candidates would love to hear your advice about what made you win the whole competition earlier this year.
When it comes to that, I think it's always hard to tell if the organization likes you or not, because it's a very fair point of view on the contestants, and it's hard to tell. But what's important to have a mindset of a winner. And when I was going to India, I just knew in my head that I don't want to just try, that I want to give it my best, and every day I'll do everything to the fullest. And of course, during the competition, especially when it comes to Beautiful Purpose dinner, many people were coming to me, even the contestants, and telling me, "Oh, you're my favorite to win," and it really warmed my heart and meant a lot for me, the support. So for me, I think one of the strongest aspects for me was the Beautiful Purpose round. And as I said, it's a heart and soul of this world, but you just need to be prepared in all the aspects, because as we know, it's many things that this world should be. And if you're really giving your best and you're living for that, I'm sure that the organization will notice you.
Thank you very much. Surprised you the most about being this world? Something that you did not expect will come with a crown?
I would never expect how amazing people you... I mean, you can expect it, but when it really happens, it definitely was much better than what I thought. On this journey, I think I created life-lasting relationships, not only with the girls, but also in each country where I go. So I think my problem right now, or problem, is that everywhere in the world I have amazing people, and it's hard to feel at home in one country, because I feel, wow, but in that country I have this amazing person, and in that country I met this amazing children. So it's so it's that, I think, the beautiful relationships I created on the way.
Thank you very much, and enjoy your stay in the Philippines.
Thank you so much, a friend of the PDI. I mean, this was feeling at home all over the world. And with that, next question from Net25.
Hello, this is Cesar from Net25. Is Christina would like to ask? I have a few questions. I have, first is, you said a while ago that you have a special relationship with Filipino because you're surrounded with a Filipino. Just elaborate it or something about it. And then my second question is, if you visit in the Philippines as a vacation, what tourist is destination that you want to go and stay with your family, friends, loved ones, and what Filipino foods that have you that you tried and that you're super capable?
Alright, so that's three. I'll try to somehow connect it all together. So the first question, the relationship with a Filipino woman. When I was growing up in my town, I had this Filipino woman. Her name was Maria Sunshine. And she was my very good friend since a very young age. I grew up with her, she was taking care of me, we became friends, and once she even told me, I had a dream, that was in the times when I was a model, she told me, I had a dream, you're not gonna be model, you'll be a pageant title holder, so she kinda even predicted the future. And with that, I also grew a love to Philippines, because she always used to tell me how beautiful Philippines are, that it's stunning because of the beaches and the natural landscape, the mountains. She even said it's more beautiful than Maldives. So to your second question, I would definitely love to visit the islands, to see the beach, because I've heard a lot about it. So far, I've seen the Manila, and the landscapes and the nature is something on my list for maybe my next visit. And when it comes to the food, I definitely tried some of the foods, but I'm very open to try even more, and I'm sure that this week I will have the chance. I already was talking that I want to try all the Filipino foods, because I had some of it and I love it. I love Filipino cuisine.
Thank you and congratulations.
What is the secret of winning the crown for you?
If I tell you, it's not secret anymore. But as I said, definitely use every moment to shine, to enjoy as well, and to give your best. For me, it was as well the preparation, because I really tried to study about this world, to know what will happen at the competition. I was preparing very long time for the talent round, for the head-to-head challenge, beauty of purpose, everything. And I'm sure that if you have the preparation, you feel more confident, and like that you can perform better. So that was my secret.
Follow-up question, what's your most favorite fast track in Miss World?
I love top model as well, of course, because I'm a model, but my most favorite was actually the beauty of purpose. The beauty of a purpose, because I knew that I have a project I was working on for 3 years, and to show to other people, to raise awareness for our school, was the best feeling ever. So for me, it's the beauty of a purpose round.
Thank you so much. And my next question is for Sir Arnold de la Villa. Sir Arnold, we all know that the Miss World Philippines coronation is fast approaching. So as a pageant fans and pageant medias who are watching right now for our live, so what can we expect from this year's edition of Miss World Philippines?
As I said a while ago, we're going to showcase the original Filipino music, and the concept is something like OPM pop culture. So you can see a lot of the music from the 50s to 60s to 70s to 80s to the present. So we're going to showcase also the Manila Symphony Orchestra as part of the show, and also a lot of surprises. I have to just watch and be there on the coronation night, so you will see what's the difference between, you know, I really work so hard on this, and to give it a good concept, and it's an entirely different kind of nature. So I'm excited to see you all, you guys, there.
Thank you so much, and that's all.
Looking forward to see you guys at the coronation night. Next question, please.
Good afternoon. If you're already malamot, later na lang. Is Miss Julia here?
She can't make it, but she will be there tonight in Charity Gala, and of course at the coronation.
I prepared a question when I'm from Malaysia. But of course, mabuhay and welcome to our country, the Philippines.
Thank you so much. And great way to start to... Okay, meron pa. Isiquel, isiquel pa tayo. Sige pa, tuloy lang.
Ahoy, Christina. I'm Chelsea Markova. What important lesson or lessons have you learned from your journey of success?
Never, never forget who you are on the journey, because you go through many situations where you may feel lost, but what always helps me to realize why I'm doing what I'm doing and who I am, where I come from, my roots, my traditions, and that's always the biggest force I have.
Final question. Why do you believe that you're a beauty with a purpose?
Ooh, I loved it. I don't believe, I know I am. I know I am, and it's because that's what I'm doing much before pageantry. Something that really comes from my heart. In the beginnings, I was not even posting that. It was something what I was doing in my free time when I have a holidays. I started in the Czech Republic and then I went to Tanzania, Africa, where I went on a regular basis. And I know that thanks to my efforts, I really helped the children in there, and it's just a hard thing. And right now I'm continuing on that. I'm trying to build on a Miss World and really be the beauty of a purpose ambassador. And I'm sure that at the end of the year, there will be many things accomplished. As I said, even the last week, I went to a mentally disabled center where I was able to donate a tablet, especially a tablet for disabled people, so they can train their motorics, play games together. So I'm doing that on a regular basis, and I'm sure that I'm not going to stop even after my Miss World journey.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, our veteran question giver. Thank you so much, mabuhay. And finally, Tim.
Hi, Christina. I'm actually with the Miss World organization, but I'm just curious. You may have heard that Sir Arnold is a respected star builder, talent manager.
Let's do something together, I'm here.
Would you, by any chance, be interested, let's say, after your reign, to consider a showbiz career in the Philippines?
If you have an Aurora role for me, I'm done. Count me in. Definitely. I think that Miss World should be full package. So we should not only be, of course, the face, but you should be a woman on different levels. And that's what Miss World is really putting the focus on. That's why we have so many different challenges at Miss World. And I think acting can be a beautiful thing to try as well. So let's see.
Do you have any acting experience of any sort? Or other talents like singing?
Acting experience. I've actually been in a few commercials, but never a big movie. So that's definitely a thing that will be new for me, but I tried some acting classes. When it comes to singing, I love to sing, but I'm not sure if I'm a singer, because before, when I was young, I was trying to do a singing, but the teacher told me, Christina, I'm not sure if this is gonna work well. It broke my heart. I wanted to be the next Hannah Montana. But you know, I love to sing, but I'm not sure if I'm a good singer, but the acting may work.
Alright. We look forward to that.
Thank you so much. Arthur will come with a role for you as a princess who does horseback riding.
Yes, please. That would be a dream role.
Thank you so much. Questions? Let's give a round of applause, please, to our Discord. Thank you so much, Arthur, for inviting the friends from the pageant and mainstream media to join us. We look forward to seeing you tonight at our charity gala and, of course, at the coronation night on Friday. In the meantime, may I please invite Mr. Pegafria together with Ms. Christina Hierofant for a few photographs.
Julia.
Can we invite now Mr. Joe over here to please join us here for the photo? And can we also invite the Grand West High team to join Sir Joe here on stage for the photo? Our friends from Grand West High, they can join us here on stage. Mr. Joe Fijardo. Thank you so much. And can we ask Kirk? Kirk, can you please join us in the photo together with Miss World? It was, and with that, let's thank Ms. Christina. Thank you so much for joining us here in the Philippines.